How many decisions have you made today? Well, depending on the time of day you're watching this video, you may have lost count. That's because it's been estimated that people make up to 35,000 decisions a day. With this relentless state of choice, how can organizations possibly make decisions quickly enough to respond to changing conditions? When teams decide to abandon consensus and move ahead when things seem safe enough to try, they're better able to respond to the demands of the moment. To learn how schools and districts have adopted this role, keep watching. Hi, I'm Megan Campion, Associate Partner with Education Elements, and welcome back to the New School Rules series. This is the fourth of six videos in our series focused on the fourth rule, aim for safe enough to try over consensus. For more context, please check out the first three videos, plan for change, not perfection, build trust and allow authority to spread, and define the work before you define the people. In this video, we'll be talking about how teams shortened the time they spent deliberating as they aimed for safe enough to try instead of consensus. We'll be talking with Joe Hochreiter, superintendent of Hendrick Hudson School District in New York, Lori Barron, Montana's superintendent of the year and superintendent at Evergreen School District in Montana, and Aviva Kafka, superintendent in Hyde Park, New York. As school leaders and their teams faced an onslaught of novel situations, unprecedented challenges, and urgent decisions, many embraced the idea that their default setting as they were approaching a decision would be yes. Aviva Kafka of Hyde Park, New York, came into her position midway through the first full year of the COVID crisis. She found that when she arrived, her existing leadership philosophy was increasingly relevant as her community dealt with the challenges presented by the pandemic.
I've had to learn, I think, over these years about how my default is really a yes. It's how I was raised, that, you know, it's only a no if it's health or safety. You know, otherwise the answer is always yes. And I think, you know, educators just want to do really cool things for kids. And most of the time they're just asking an administrator to pay for it or help set it up or something like that, and that we should not be lazy about that or dismissive about that. And so what I've had to learn, though, is that I can't always make it happen right now, or sometimes there's just too many things going and people get overwhelmed, so I can't say yes to everything. So I've just had to learn how to, you know, slow it down a little bit to make sure that everyone's really ready to take on something new.
In Montana, Lori Barron and her team also found themselves shifting their default to yes.
My leadership beliefs and mentality are about people being able to take risk and people being able to not have to have permission. And if you have strong structures in place, and for us, we have a strong strategic plan, our mission is clear. If you're following that strategic plan and mission and what you're doing is not illegal, immoral, unethical, or unsafe, I will be on your side every time, even if I would have done it differently.
This mindset shift in Evergreen School District actually extended to an adaptation of their traditional practices for interviewing and hiring.
In the middle of this pandemic, we had an opening at our elementary principal. And so we brought our team together and we got a large team, larger than we might have normally, which gave more input because we wanted to be super attentive to buy-in and participation in the process. When we came down to our top candidate, it was our top couple of candidates as we were narrowing down through the process, it was, can we support this person? Instead of, no, I have to have my choice or no one else. You know, it wasn't, here's my choice, four people for this person, three people for this person, five people for this person. We went away from that. We said, let's talk about consensus of, can we support someone? Not consensus of everybody has to vote one for the other. And is this person safe enough for us? Is this someone we can all believe in and buy in, even if it wasn't your first choice? And it changed our entire interview process, right? Of, in the end, every person on that committee said, yes, this is a person I can work with.
Starting from a bias toward action with an inclination to say yes provided a real starting point for teams to make decisions more quickly. As teams sped up decision-making, they also sped up learning. In Hendrick Hudson, Joe Hochreiter and his team experienced the benefits of learning through action and paying attention to feedback.
as we went through April and May, and ultimately the year ended in June, we got better at what we were doing, A, because we had no choice, but B, we had real-time feedback. And when you're a classroom teacher, kids will tell you, they'll let you know if what you're doing is working or not. And when kids are at home and moms and dads are at home, you have now increased your audience for feedback. And we got a lot of it, and thank goodness that we did, because otherwise we could have been going down a different path. We could have been going down a path that we thought was working when families and kids are clamoring for something different.
The time crunch experienced in New York was experienced all over the country. In Montana, Lori and her team found that their meeting structures shifted to accommodate the need to act quickly.
You know, it used to be, we all show up and sit around the small table in my office and I give out the agenda. When we went to remote learning in the spring, we couldn't do that. And so we started meeting through Google Meet. And then when we returned, administrators returned on campus, we didn't want to be tight and close together, right? So we moved into our boardroom. Because the time we were remote, I started making our agenda ahead of time and sharing it with people. You know, what used to be, you know, a standard 3-hour meeting now is usually, you know, an hour and a half, because they have the agenda ahead of time. They can review it ahead of time. I mean, what was I thinking? That it wouldn't have been a good idea to share it with them ahead of time for 7 years prior to a pandemic. Now we're able to make some decisions outside of being together, which we did that before as well. It's not like we only did it together, but we're doing a lot more collaboration on a regular basis instead of just a once a week basis. And so those kind of collaborations are really changing how we do business, because our collaborations are more consistent and more ongoing and more collaborative from the beginning.
Defaulting to yes and learning quickly enabled many school districts to keep making progress in the face of enormous challenges. As they did this work, some teams noticed that breaking down really large problems into more digestible bites was enabling the teams to achieve really big things. In Hyde Park, Aviva Kafka and her team broke down large challenges into a series of smaller decisions with really clear owners, so that people knew how to make progress within their locus of control.
So Jim Wright, who's like the father of response to intervention, he was doing some work with our district on our RTI, you know, process, and did some observations of us and said, you know, you folks have a lot of high level meetings for low level decisions. Like, you've got, you know, six administrators at a table making a decision that really could be made at the classroom level, for example. So, you know, maybe think about that. And that to me shows that if you are doing that, you don't have a lot of trust in your people. And that's a problem. You know, there are too many decisions to be made. It's like impossible. And, you know, it's really micromanaging, to use an old fashioned term. I think that there is a parallel process between teachers trusting kids, principals trusting teachers, district level administrators trusting principals. Kids are hardwired to learn. So, you know, trusting that, it's like, how do we have a developmentally appropriate, engaging, culturally responsive curriculum that engages kids? So I see the same thing, like, what do adult learners need? You know, what do teachers and paraprofessionals and administrators need to grow? When we do that, then teachers can be really empowered to make decisions in their own classroom.
In Hendrick Hudson, Superintendent Hawkrider and his team broke their decisions into increments, so they achieved significant change by taking very small steps.
We completely redesigned public education in front of the world in a matter of weeks, and that's really what happened. If you were to give public education in New York State the task of doing what we've done in the last 9 months, it would take 10 years to accomplish. In terms of having stakeholder input and feedback and testing different models and getting data and perfecting it. And we didn't have time to perfect it. We had to do no harm, and we had to use our heart and our head to make sure that kids got what they needed, that parents felt supported, and that there was a sense of normalcy during a time in our life, and hopefully it's the only time in our life, that was anything but normal. And we owed that to our kids, and our staff really pulled it off. And for that, I'm grateful.
These district leaders and their teams aimed for safe enough to try over consensus. And the shifts that they made in their mindset and practices will continue to impact the way they make decisions and move the work forward. Next up in our series, we'll be exploring how responsive leaders managed communication with their stakeholders in times of uncertainty and rapid change, when they harnessed the flow and let information go. Be sure to check out our website and follow us on Twitter for more content. Check out the description for links to all of these and more. If you enjoyed this content, be sure to like our video and subscribe to our channel. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you next time.